Hello everyone, Michael here, and today I'm going to be showing my latest plugin that I'm calling Object Path Converter. Unlike that lengthy plugin name, I'm hoping to keep this video short but still informative, so let's get into it. If you script a lot in Roblox Studio, you'll know that tapping out long object path locations is a tedious process, especially if you're using the WaitForChild method. This plugin makes it easier to create common object paths by displaying a list of all selected objects with their paths. You can even switch between using WaitForChild and the original path method by toggling the checkbox. There are two ways that you can copy the information to use in your scripts. You can select the path in the text box by double-clicking and copying it with your native keyboard controls. Another method will be to press the Output List to Console button. Clicking this button will print all selected object paths to the output window for you to copy from there. The plugin works with object names that have spaces or other characters that would cause problems using the non-WaitForChild method, so it should work on any object that you need a path to. Now that I've explained all the features, let's talk about a limitation that the plugin faces. The limitation is that the plugin has to start from scratch every time the selection changes. This is due to Roblox not providing a list of changes when the selection event fires. This is likely due to the fact that a developer could have selected or deselected a single object, or it could have affected all of the objects. Recalculating on every selection change is not necessarily going to cause performance issues outside of the stress testing that are performed in the plugin. Most developers won't need to calculate the object paths of thousands of objects at the same time. I tested it on around 1600 objects on an Intel i5-4460, and it took about 2 seconds to calculate. This limitation is pretty minor and won't affect the majority of users, so I'm satisfied with the state of the plugin at the moment. If you have any questions or suggestions about the plugin as well as ideas for new plugins, feel free to leave a comment below and I'll look into it. If you want to check out the plugin for yourself, link will be in the description. Thanks for watching and I'll see you all in the next one. This is the third time that I've re-recorded the audio for this video. I hope it's good. I'm not doing that again.